Belle here. I'm finna cut some more grass, and I'm on my tractor because my husband, he thinks my tractor's sexy. So anyway, I'm in the middle of picking things like blades of grass and twigs out of my teeth or whatever, because I'm on crazy terrain here on my property. I live, as you can see probably behind me, on a type of farm, not with animals, but it's a farm, and it's a lot to take care of. And so I thought, as I was out here cutting grass, listen to the sexy sound of a weed whacker over there in the background. That's my gardener over there, a landscaper. Well, I ain't gonna tell y'all about him just yet. That's another day. But I figured as I was out here, I would share the wealth of knowledge I've got stored up here while I'm out here in nature, in the God-given nature. And well, I'm gonna get started. I'm gonna switch hands here so I can start up my John Deere. all right, I'll do this. Yeah, I hope y'all can hear me. Got the blades going, and we're off. I find that one of the best ways to cut grass with the tractor specifically is to not take yourself too serious. It's easy to take yourself serious when you're looking cool on a tractor. But the reality is, it's all fun. It's all fun, and you gotta get her done, and you just wanna live your best life here. And so what I'm doing is a little unconventional, to say the least. I do kind of like an anti-pattern pattern. I'll show you what I'm talking about. Hold on just a minute, and I'll turn her around here. If you could see, I just kind of try to, I go in a bit of a circuit, not a circle, a circuit. So I am kind of continuing to go round and round. Betsy, you can do it. She can do it. All right, I'm gonna flip it back around to me, because I know that can get kind of boring to look at. Turn her around here, get back on my laps. So, today is Wednesday, and we are in April. First really nice day for me to hop onto the John Deere. Why not post something to the tube of you? Or as the young ones say, YouTube. Whoa, buddy. Whoa, buddy. Sometimes I gotta dodge things. Oh. And sometimes most of the time I'd say I'm pretty good at it. Sometimes I come out a little beat up, but that's life on the farm for you. Scratches and rashes. Nothing too alarming though, nothing contagious. Ain't never had poison ivy in all my life. Nope. I messed with other types of poison, but never caught the poison ivy. So I thought I'd also start out by telling you a little bit about myself again. My name's Belle. After that real cute pretty little Disney princess with the half a dozen dwarves. No, I'm not named after a Disney princess. My name, Belle. My mama. That's all right. On to the next. So my mama named me Belle. Actually, I'm named after a drink. A really nice drink we have on a Wednesday brunch. It's called a Bellini. Some of y'all, if you're from parts where I'm from, But my mama, she did once visit outside of where we grew up, and she learned about a drink called a Bellini and thought, what a beautiful name to name a little. Ooh, that one stung. Oh. Anyway, so I'm named after a Bellini, but you can call me Belle for short. That didn't sound too good. You could kill me with garlic. I know y'all know what that means, right? If you don't, I was meaning like white like a vampire. So anywho, I put on the old block of sunblocker on the nose. It's a bottle of sunblock I found from about 3 summers ago. But hey, what are you gonna do? I mixed it with a little bit of butter just to thicken it up, because I do not a red nose tomorrow. Do not. We know how unattractive that is on a lady. Alright, well, I'm gonna finish off this little patch here, and then I'm gonna call it a day for my vlog. My vlog. That's a vlog with a V. Kind of like a blog, but a V for a video, I think. Definitely not for a valedictorian. No siree, I don't want to mislead you. What you see is what you get. Alright, so I'm going to stop here, and actually I'm going to stop up there.